Yessayan's book, Averagneru Mech, In the Ruins, is considered one of her masterpieces. The reason is that she is able to not only observe and write about what happened in Adana, she's able to be a voice for the survivors. She's able to bear witness to their struggle, to their efforts for freedom, for their search for light and life. The massacres of Adana occurred in April of 1909. So it's less than a year after the restoration of the Constitution. In 1908, the Young Turks come in and restore the Constitution from 1876, which brought greater human rights to everyone in the empire, and particularly to the minorities. And the Armenians were quite optimistic at this time. The switch from the Sultan to something which was more constitutional and representative in nature was very dramatic for the empire. But during this period, it raised a lot of unrest, and there were many conservative Muslims who did not want to see change. Particularly in Adana, there were mobs that started to attack the Armenians. The Patriarchate is the religious leadership of the Armenian community in Constantinople. They were the leadership of really the Armenians in the entire empire. They asked Zabel Yessayan to be part of the second delegation to go to Adana to provide relief for the orphans. They didn't specifically state that they wanted her to write about what she saw, but that was probably in their minds as well. The fact that Zabel was asked to go on this mission is quite amazing because she wasn't a doctor or a nurse. She was a writer, and so they obviously saw her as a leader in the community. So Zabel Yessayan arrived in Adana 3 months after the massacres had taken place, and she immediately started to visit the orphanages, and she saw what terrible condition the orphanages were in, and the orphans themselves were really suffering from malnutrition, from lack of adequate care. So when she went to visit, she did everything in her power to try to improve the situation. She worked directly with missionaries who were there. She came head to head with Cemal Pasha, who later became one of the three leaders of the Young Turks who perpetrated the Armenian genocide 6 years later. And she argued about the treatment of the Armenians. Specifically, she wanted the Armenian children to be taught Armenian in the Ottoman orphanage, and he categorically refused. But it was very important to the Armenians. They wanted to maintain the identity of the children. They believed that this was extremely important for their ability to develop intellectually, morally, and just to become true citizens. They needed to be able to speak their mother tongue. They needed to be able to understand who they were. The community was not only physically under a great deal of danger, but morally, they were totally devastated. So this was something she was dealing with, this sense of hopelessness among the people, and she wanted to do something to try to change that. When Zabel came to Adana at that point, she was 31 years old, she had already developed a strong sense of activism and social justice. But now she was seeing injustice on a very different scale, and she became extremely active. So it was no longer only, you know, writing about it. She was speaking about it. She was taking it on upon herself to fight this injustice. So after 3 months of seeing what's happening in Adana and the surrounding regions, she goes back to Constantinople and she feverishly writes her book, In the Ruins, and it's published less than 2 years later in 1911. And in her book and in the preface, she makes it very clear that this is a very political book, that she is writing it not only for the Armenian community, but for the entire Ottoman fatherland, because she wants to demonstrate how the Armenian people who had supported progress, who had supported the new constitution, and had supported human rights were targeted for that very reason by the conservative element, the reactionaries, who didn't want change. So she was appealing to those Turks and to all members of the community, of the larger community, who did believe in human rights, to look at this, to face what had happened squarely. And she said that if they do not do this, if they do not face the truth about what happened, then tyranny will return to this country over and over again.